Hello guys, you are with the Tech Science. Today we discuss a new point. The point is from the chapter Effect of Electric Current, and the name of the point is called Joule's Law, also called as like the questions are also like in two different manner. The first one, derive an expression for Joule's Law along with the statement, and sometimes the question like that, obtain an expression for the heat energy produced from the metallic conductor when a current flows for some time. In that case also, we have like an expression for that, and that expression nothing but the expression for the Joule's Law. Before starting the actual point, we have one diagram. On the basis of this diagram, we can derive the expression for the Joule's Law. Here we have a cell, a battery is there, and this battery is used to supply the energy for the charge to flow from one point to another point. The flow of current, of course, always we follow the conventional current, and here the conventional current starting from positive terminal of the battery, and again the circuit get completed and it moved toward the negative terminal. Here we have a resistance R is there here, this, and the charge flow, actually we consider for the Joule's Law that the flow of charge is from point A to point B via this resistance R. Here ammeter is there, ammeter is used to measure the current in a circuit. We have the voltmeter, it is used to measure the potential difference, and there is a key. This key is used for on and off purpose, that is called, right now the key is on, means there is a flow of current in a circuit. Some of the basic terminologies that we already know, just I revise within a single sentence. What is the definition of current? Current denoted by the letter I. So current is nothing but the charge flow per unit time. This is the formula for current. So this is what the definition of electric current. The charge flow per unit time through a cross-sectional area of the conductor is called electric current. What about the potential difference? The amount of work done required to move a unit positive charge from one point to another point. This is what the formula for potential difference. So V is for potential difference. The amount of work done to move a unit positive charge, that is what, Q, from one point to another point, nothing but called as the electric potential difference. We have one more law that we already know, that is called Ohm's law, and the formula for Ohm's law is equal to V is equal to IR, or I is equal to V upon R, and a number of different formulas are there. So you must know these three things. First, electric current. Second, electric potential difference. And third is Ohm's law. So as just now, before starting this point, just I assume that you know all these three basic concepts very clearly. If not, you can see the videos of the Tech Science, so you got clear idea what about electric potential difference is there, what is current is there, and what is the Ohm's law. Right now we are discussing the Joule's law here. Suppose electric charge is there, and this electric charge is moving from point A to point B. So some kind of work will be done on this charge Q. Now question is, what, who supply the energy for this electric charge to move from point A to point B? So the answer is that this battery, or this cell, of course it is a battery, so this battery actually supply the energy to the charge that is flow from point A to point B, and the energy supplied by this battery will be given to the resistance R via this charge. So here, how much work will be done to move the charge from point A to point B? This work done is equal to V into Q. From where I derive this expression? I'm deriving the expression from this. That is V is equal to W upon Q. Suppose we take work on the left hand side. So what is there? There is a multiplication. And this way, this V is nothing but the potential difference across point A to point B. So this much of work is required to move the charge from point A to point B, and this energy supplied by this charge to move from point A to point B is given by this battery. Okay, now question is, what about the formula for power? Power equal to work upon time. Power equal to work upon time. So here this work is nothing but what? This work is nothing but the energy supplied by the battery. That's why I can replace this, the energy given by the battery divided by how much time the energy will be supplied to move a unit positive charge from point A to point B. Now here, this is what the equation number one for this energy, that is what V that is called potential difference from point A to point B into Q, divided by, for the time we have the formula T. So this is the formula, P is equal to V into Q upon T. Now, as we know that some of the basic formulas are there. So this is the word basic formula that you must remember, that is what the current, the formula for current, I is equal to Q upon T. So instead of Q upon T, can I put the value of I? Yes. Yes or no? Yes. So here we have the formula like Q upon T. So can I replace this Q upon T with the help of the formula called I is equal to Q upon T? So instead of Q upon T, I am putting the value of I. So here P is equal to V into I. This is what we call it as a equation number 2. So just by taking the reference of the first formula, that is called basic formula required to understood the Joule's law. Now, question is what? The amount of heat energy, the amount of heat energy supplied by this battery on the charge Q, then the charge passing from point A to point B, this energy is given to the resistance R. The energy supplied by the battery is through via charge Q given to the resistor R. Now, this resistor R utilizes this energy, and here this electrical energy gets converted into the heat energy. The electrical energy supplied by the battery utilized by the resistor R, then it will be converted into the heat energy. Now, question is what? How much heat energy will be absorbed by this resistance, or the energy that is called heat energy? What is the intensity of the heat energy? The intensity of the heat energy is totally depends upon the two things. What is the ratio for the heat? It is more heated, it is less heated. What is the quantity? What is the intensity? Of course, if there is a flow of charge continuously for a time, a fixed time will be there, for 1 minute, for 2 minutes, for 3 minutes. As the time passes, the resistors get more heated. What does this mean? It means that the power of the amount of heat generated, with the help of this resistor R is depend upon how much power supplied by the battery for how much time. Am I right now? So if you want more heat, of course more energy with more time, energy will be fixed although, but more time, the amount of energy given by this battery, if it is more amount of heat. If heat will be less, what does it mean? The energy will be given by this battery for some less time. Of course, two factors are responsible for that. Number one, how much energy will be given and for how much time. If time is more, heat is more. If time is less, heat is less. So it is what? H equal to P into T. But if you observe, what about the value of P? P is nothing but V into I. Just now we derive the expression. That's why H equal to V into I into T. Yes, can I put this value? Yes. So this is what the first formula, H equal to V into I into T. Now, third basic formula. What is the basic formula? Ohm's law. V is equal to IR. So instead of this value V, can I put up the IR? Yes. So instead of V, I am putting IR, reference from this equation number 3. Now, this IT becomes as it is. So if you derive the expression further, this I and this I become I square, and this is what RT as it is. So in short, we can say that H equal to I square RT is nothing but called as the Joule's law. What is this? This is a Joule's law. So this is what the final equation for the Joule's law. Now, can you design the statement of Joule's law? Yes. What is the Joule's law? The amount of heat generated in a conductor which having the resistance R and the amount of current I pass through it for a time t is directly proportional to, number one, square of the current, number two, resistance of the conductor, and number three, time for which current flows. Again, I'm repeating one more time. The amount of heat generated in a conductor having resistance R when the current I flows through a conductor for time t is directly proportional to, number one, square of the current flows through a conductor, number two, resistance of the conductor, and number three, the time for which the current flow through a conductor. So here, this is what the final expression for the Joule's law. I hope you like the video. If you like the video, please subscribe my channel and press on the bell icon for the new notification. Thank you.